Hey, it's Rich Birdsall here, and Restaurant Week going on for one more day. The last place that I got to stop and check out was Strange Brew over on South Washington Street, right here in the heart of Binghamton. Now, as you'll see here, Lisa is proudly displaying both menus, which we never got to use because they literally brought out everything on the menu and more for us, which was great. We were wicked full, and everything was ridiculously tasty. So I'll pause here for a moment, and we'll put in some elevator music so you can read the menu. You got it? All right, perfect. First off was the soup, which wasn't on the menu. That was delicious. Nice little vegetable medley. Then coming up was the macaroni and cheese, which was definitely on the menu. The first one you see on the left, that's the four cheese mac and cheese. Cheddar, Munster, Gruyere, and Pecorino. The one on the right, buffalo chicken. Cheddar, roasted, shredded chicken, and sriracha buffalo sauce. If you know me, I like the spicy stuff. So, yep. Broke the vegan rule today, the tasty way. Up next, here's the sample of the sandwiches, which weren't on the menu, but they were tasty. Brisket, and I believe the other one was chicken. Either way, they were all ridiculously good. Like, if you're gonna get a sandwich, this is the spot. And then the desserts, which are incredible because they make them right there. No joke. Those two chocolate-looking things in the middle, those are two chocolate macaroons. They actually made the top part, which was the top and bottom, well, buns, if you will. They're like brownie, and in the middle is like this cappuccino or espresso-flavored chocolate. Oh, God. It was really, really good. Rest of the pastries, apple walnut bar, a mixed berry cheesecake bar, and a chocolate raspberry cheesecake bar. If you like sweet stuff, I'm not a huge sweet stuff guy, but if you like sweet stuff, this is the place to go. Your sweet tooth will be singing like the angels upon high. Beverages. Remember, still is a full-service coffee shop, so hot and iced coffee and tea always available. They have this iced Hawaiian green tea that you need to try out. That was pretty fruity and tasty. Lisa got that one. And there is a house-brewed strawberry lemonade that you want to get your hands on as well when it starts getting a little warm outside, whenever that is. Now, as usual, I gathered them all up, and we sat down on the couch, and we spoke for a little bit about the business and what's going on. So let's go take a look and listen to that.
So here we are, it's Restaurant Week, and we are at Strange Brew. Now, how long have you guys been here?
We've been here, I'd say, about 2 months.
Yeah?
We kind of set up shop sometime in the end of January and just started remodeling and working on this place and getting it going. Officially, we've had our soft opening last week, and now we're just kind of easing into it, getting a feel for the community.
Yeah, I mean, it looks great in here. Great improvement on the inside. And I noticed you have real coffee beans on the wall over there.
Yeah.
So are those imported from someplace?
Those are actually straight from our roaster. So we use a local roaster, and we wanted to do something with the wall that would kind of show people from the outside that, you know, we're serious about our coffee. What better way than a giant wall of coffee beans?
Without a doubt. How far does that go back? So we might have to.
Oh my goodness. That actually goes into the next building.
Right, 480 back.
Yeah, they literally just open on their side and get fresh coffee coming out.
Yeah, that's awesome. Don't believe absolutely any of that. So, the food here was delicious, and I don't know if you know this or not, even though when you walk in, it looks, acts, smells like a coffee shop, but you guys have a full kitchen in the back too, which you saw all the food that we got from here. You don't get sandwiches and macaroni and cheese from a coffee shop. So what made you want to put the full kitchen in the back of just your what could have been your run-of-the-mill coffee shop?
I don't know. I guess for me, I wanted to be in a place where I could always get the types of things that I crave.
Right.
And I mean, macaroni and cheese is something that, if you do it right, it'll be a full course meal for you. And we take pride in that. We put, you know, different things like bacon and brisket. We cook the brisket here, and we have different cheeses that we like to blend the mac and cheese with in order to get a main course dish out of something that's typically served as like a side item or an appetizer.
Yeah, without a doubt. And all of that was real delicious. And another thing too, the desserts, for Pete's sake.
Thanks, all her.
This looked like something that you would get from one of those fancy New York shops that your buddy may be working in.
It's all homemade.
Yeah,
all homemade,
and then we learned that this young lady did it right here. They were perfect. Like, they looked perfect. And they tasted great, too. So, I mean, you can have something that looks perfect, but it tastes like cardboard. So, but you had both of that together. You do all of that here.
We do all of that here, yeah. And, you know, we try to do a little bit of everything. So something with nuts, a little something with, you know, fruits, and then you have the chocolate, you know, just to have like a nice overall blend of everything. Coming soon, we're going to be expanding our line of French macarons. Mm-hmm. So for now, you know, we're trying to get a feel for what flavors people like and stuff. But that's our kind of next big dessert.
I gotta
endeavor.
Be honest, all the flavors, you'll end up liking.
Oh yeah, Oreos is my favorite. Definitely.
Yeah, for sure. So why don't you tell the good folk here where you're at in case they don't know where Strange Brew is.
Cool, so we're located right on Washington Street. Our address is 137 Washington, and we're between Holly and Court. We're smack in the middle of the block, and you won't miss us. If you look past, you'll see the big Coney Island-style lights right in the window, and we have a nice little artisanal wooden sign that was made for us with our logo on it, so you can't miss us. We're right in the middle there.
And you're, what, 7 to 7, I heard?
Yeah, we're doing, right now our hours are 7 a.m. to 7 p.m., we also do a full line of breakfast, so we do omelets, we have breakfast sandwiches, we also do our own parfaits and old-fashioned oatmeal. So we're from 7 to 7, Monday through Thursday, Friday from 7 till midnight, and then Saturday we're from 8 till midnight, and then Sunday we're from 8 to 6 or 5 o'clock, depending on how the response is going to be.
Right, well, along with the colleges out here at night, too. That's going to be great.
Absolutely. I mean, our whole thing with the Friday and Saturday you know, hours are to be able to attract a late night crowd. We have a special platform in the front that has tables and chairs in the daytime, and on Friday and Saturday we move those out and we have a full-fledged stage, and we want to be able to do live music and not just, you know, have it in the background, but actually have people come here, dim the lights, and feature local bands and artists.
Right, and have your a little bit different of a coffee shop.
Exactly.
Because I'm used to seeing like lounge singers with like, you know, the guitar or whatever.
Yeah.
And that'll be,
I think we want to, again, like with everything else, we want to do a healthy mix. So if the music, you know, if the music and musicians are good, we'll give them a chance. Acoustic, rock, anything.
Right.
We've been
really
considering doing some stand-up comedy, you know.
Kind of we have a lot of great comedians in this area, too. So there you have it. We're at Strange Brew. Want to try it out for Restaurant Week. You guys like the Restaurant Week thing?
Oh, it's been phenomenal. I mean, what better way to open than with a big bang like Restaurant Week? I mean, we've had a lot of response from Restaurant Week, and so far, so good. We're overwhelmed in a good way.
Yeah, three courses, fixed prices, one for lunch, and one for dinner. Thanks for joining us, and we'll catch up with you with our next Restaurant Week. This was 2016.
Well, that's it. Binghamton Restaurant Week. One more day to check out all the fine restaurants in this area involved in Restaurant Week. Get out there, get yourself that discounted lunch, get yourself that discounted dinner, and really put the boots to this. Bite into it. You're gonna love local with Binghamton Restaurant Week.